Before you come at me about this video, let me explain.
I be feeling like I don't be popping enough, I be humble. I'ma keep showing my ass if I want to. Hang up the phone on their ass, block the number. I told you don't play with me, nigga.
I wanted to do this video because there was a time before I had gotten my bag that I wanted to get another one, and it was so hard to get. Like, when even on the website in yellow and bold, it says bag sell out in minutes. They are not joking. So I was searching around just to see, like, if I could get a bag from another website like Depop, Mercari, OfferUp, you know, just places where people sell stuff. And I was noticing a lot of people had bags, and I was like, okay, how is everyone getting a bag? I mean, of course they sell out in minutes, but some of these colors haven't been restocked since they first came out. So how is everyone getting these bags? Then I just so happened to see a tweet where someone had said that Telfar bags are now on AliExpress. And then it hit me. I was like, are people walking around with fake Telfars? I just wanted to sort of bring awareness in relation to trying to find this bag on a third party website versus the original source. If you don't know, a Telfar bag, or Telfar, is basically not even up and coming. It's a brand that's been out since 2005. It's based in New York, and currently their shopping bags are like the new Birkins, the new It bags. Like, celebrities have gotten them, but they're a black luxury designer, and they have been selling out in minutes, literally in minutes. And they have restocks that are sort of at random as far as colors and sizes. They come in a small, medium, and large. And, you know, they're very hard to get, honestly. Get one, it's like you're in the It Club. I'm not even mad about them being on AliExpress, because AliExpress is like, it's the place of knockoff, it's the place of cheap, it's the place of inexpensive. Like, almost any designer thing that you want, you can find the knockoff on AliExpress. Like, they even have a thing on the app now where if you take a picture of something that you want, you can put it in their search engine and they will find something similar to it or exactly like it, and it's like 90% off in a sense. I wasn't even mad that I saw Telfar on AliExpress. I was concerned about the amount of people who have bought these fake bags on AliExpress. And it's even like current bags, you know? It's not even like people have been buying these months ago. Like, if you look at the reviews, there are some people on there who have bought bags like last month, last week. So I was like, maybe it is a good knockoff. Like, I kind of want to see and compare it to my real Telfar. So before we go in the comments, I do have the real Telfar bag, and I want to compare it to a fake one that I bought from AliExpress. And I'm going to talk about both of them. This is the original real Telfar. This is exactly what it came in. This is the bag from AliExpress. This is the packaging slip. The shopping bag, the cream color, it said on the 5th, so if you want to check that was when the restock was, like, I'm telling you, this is the real one. That is the company. This is the real. I'm going to take this one out so we can see just off the sense of the packaging. Oh, wow. So starting off, they do, I bought the red one. I also wanted to buy the red one to also experiment on social media. I wanted to see if I post this bag, I wanted to see if people gonna, like, I don't know, I just wanted to see if they would know that it's fake or something, just to see, like, could they tell the difference, or would they just be like, oh, she got another Telfar. So I wanted to see, like, from the naked eye of another perspective, could you tell that this was fake? AliExpress, they give you a tea bag. The only difference is this has the dusting bag for the actual bag that they place in it, and this is just shipping. There's only a T on the outside. It's not another bag. It's not another bag on the inside. It actually looks like a stamp. It looks a little faded. It's smaller than the original. Is if you buy a bag probably from a third party, if it doesn't come exactly like this with the two T's, and another thing with the small, where is it? With the small tag on the back, it's most likely fake. Oh. Okay, this is small. This looks smaller, but I mean, it fits in my hand. Doesn't smell. It's a cute color. I can tell within the detail of the stitching that this is definitely a knockoff. Okay, so this is the fake. This is just first off before I go into major detail. Beautiful. So these are it. First things first, another thing to look for as far as a knockoff, if you want to go through a third party, is the white tag. Now, who knows, AliExpress might advance and start putting the white tag on, but so far, there's no Telfar tag. When I first pulled it out, there's no tag anywhere actually. What I was noticing is the stitching. The stitching on the red bag seems rushed in a few places, like in the corners, in basically those places you wouldn't necessarily look at, whereas the Telfar is, the stitching is beautiful. The stitching is perfect. Like, that's something you would have to be close on the eyes to see. And I also noticed, like, within the corners of the bag, like, it seems like whatever they use to fully put the bag together, it looks like there's some type of glue-like red substance on it. I already see a few scratches on the bag from the fake bag. So that also lets me know that the leather is not all that. And this bag kind of looks stretched. I'm not certain if it's all Telfars or just the cream color, but there's like a pearl, gloss type of finish. Maybe that's to protect the leather, or maybe that's just the finish of all bags. I'm not certain, but there's no type of shine or gloss to this leather. The biggest thing of it all is the logo. Truthfully, aside from looking at those minor details, the bags are the same size and the logo looks relatively the same. The logo on the red bag looks a little bit more pressed in, whereas the cream color, it's protruding out more. But that's what I'm saying, like, those small details, like, looking far away, if I was to see somebody with this, I'd be like, oh, she got her a Telfar, like her cute little bag. But close up, they're minor details, but they're kind of like the biggest details. That's the luxury of a Telfar bag. The genuine leather, the stitching, the finish, the cuteness, you know? The biggest thing of it all is the tag on the inside. So this is the brand tag on the inside. And sure enough, they have the same tag on the fake one. I'm looking at it, and like I said, it is poorly stitched. You could see the stitching on the top of it versus the Telfar, where it's just perfectly stitched into it. So my hands are together. And they are relatively the same. I'm gonna measure it. Let me see. The length is 22 inches. The length is 20 inches. The length is 21 inches. So it's an inch off from the real one. But also, I think they purposely had to do that because, I mean, you can't make a bag just the same as the other one, because then you know, there would be no point in getting the bag from Telfar website when you can get the exact one, not a replica, but the exact one from, you know, AliExpress. Plus, they probably didn't want to be sued. The overall point of the video was to just show that, but also bring awareness that if you really seriously want to buy from a third party, I personally wouldn't consider it, or have that person take pictures of everything, like every single thing. Have them take pictures of the packaging, the inside, the outside. Look for the details like the stitching, the corners. Even if you want to go above and beyond, tell them to measure the straps. Like, do whatever you can, because if you're not getting it from the actual website, there's a 90% chance that it might be fake. Thank you for watching this video. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you for continuing to watch my lovely channel, and I will see you all in my next video.